Hello students, today we will discuss about cell, the functional and structural unit of life. This is the 8th chapter of class 8. Now let's begin with the chapter, how and why the cell is called the structural and functional unit of life. If somebody asks you to justify the statement that why the cell is called the structural and functional unit of life, the answer will be why it is called structural unit, because all living beings, their body is made up of cells. So their structure or the structural setup is because of the cell. So all living beings are made up of cells. That's why the cell is called the structural unit of life. And if we say functional, so we say that cells perform all the basic functions which are important for the existence of the living being or for the survival. So that's why we say that cell is called the functional unit of life. So hence we have justified the statement why the cell is called the basic unit or basic structural and functional unit of life. Not only this, on the other way it is also said as the building block of the life or the fundamental unit of the life, because fundamental means basic. Basic functions are performed by the cell, or at basic level cell combines together to form tissue, then tissues combine together to form organ, and higher level of organization will be organ system, and finally living organism's body is made. So this is how we can say that the basic unit or the smallest unit of this whole organization of the living world is based on the cell. Now the next topic is about the discovery of the cell, how the cell was discovered, when it was discovered. So the story goes like this, story of the discovery of cell, that it was discovered by the Robert Hooke in 1665. Actually what he did, he took a bark of the oak tree, and bark is also called cork. So he took the very thin slice of the bark or the cork of the oak tree. The tree was oak tree, and because the bark is considered to be the dead cell, so actually he discovered the dead cell, because the credit of discovering the living cell goes to Anton van Leeuwenhoek. Somewhere in 1674 he discovered the living cell for the first time. What he did, he took the pond water and he observed the living cell in the pond water. So the credit of discovery of living cell, first living cell, goes to Leeuwenhoek, and the credit of discovering the first cell goes to Robert Hooke in 1665. When he discovered the cell for the first time, he observed it under his own self-made microscope. The microscope was not so advanced and refined. He himself made the microscope, and this is how he discovered the cell. He gave all his observation and he reported all the observation in Micrographia General, and what he observed was honeycomb like structure, which is something like that. Nothing was there inside, it means no nucleus, no cytoplasm. Why it was so? Because the cells were dead cells and it looked like a honeycomb structure. So this is the figure. You can see cork cells are, as observed by the Robert Hooke, you can see box like structure in the cork. He observed such structures. Nothing was there inside the cell. Why? Because the cells were dead. And this is the microscope, the crude microscope or not so refined or advanced microscope used by the Robert Hooke. And this is how the modern light microscopes, which you have already seen in the labs, they look like. So the crude microscope used by Hooke was not so refined, not advanced, but later on with advancement, nowadays we can see all the, or not only the cell, we can see the organelles, which are the parts, subcellular parts also, because of the advancement in the field of all these instruments. So nowadays we have got electron microscope. Also, with the help of electron microscope, we can see the cell plus subcellular structures also, which are present inside the cell. Now next topic is related to the cell theory. What is cell theory and what does it states? So cell theory is actually it was given by the German biologist Schwann and Schleiden. Basically it was given by them in 1838, and according to them they said that all living organisms are made up of cell, and the cell is the structural or the basic unit of life. And one more thing was there, that is, new cells arise from the old cell. This third one was added by R. Virchow or Rudolf Virchow. So this is how the cell theory goes. Very easy, we have already discussed on the onset of the chapter. Thank you very much.